Welcome to yet another exciting episode of Star Tales. Today we have Kumaril Kapoor, who is Senior Director of Engineering at Cisco Systems. Let's hear some inspiring stories.
And let's begin with the journey. So Kumaril, we would like to understand your perspective on your professional journey. Can we have a few words from your side?
Sure. First of all, Anil and Rama, thanks for having me here. Really happy to be part of it. And sharing some of my, experiences and journey, if that can really help, I'm definitely going to be very happy. So, about my journey, I graduated from NIT Calicut in 94. And it used to be called REC back then. It seems to be, a long time back. And post that, I joined HAL Hyderabad as part of the campus recruitment and spent a couple of years there working on, the so-called, LCA project, which was really the big one at that point of time. It carried on for quite some time. And post that, I joined Future Software Chennai, and that was my real introduction onto the telecom and networking services. And it was amazing experience, really learning the applications in the telecom domain specifically, and getting introduced to the networking world also from the practical experience standpoint. We did a couple of telecom projects for Hyundai, Samsung, and I still remember that after a few months of integrating multiple pieces of software in their telephone exchange, when the CTO made the first call, we could literally feel the packets flowing through the software, what we had written. And the kind of satisfaction you get as an engineer or the person who was involved in the design and implementation of that, I think nothing beats that. And then being on networking, next step was to join networking giant Cisco, as Cisco had just started the engineering operations in Bangalore. And I would say this has been history. The lot of young generation might feel, what is this guy, doing for so many number of years in Cisco, but not if you're really onto the fun ride called Cisco. And I started here as software engineer, working on the system software, implementing, various modules with respect to that, and for very successful products as well, right? And in around 2004, that is when I moved on to the management side and led, starting from small projects for service provider products and then kind of taking responsibilities for the products, which were running with almost 1 billion run rate during 2007-08 time. And it was a big responsibility from that standpoint and made me learn a lot of new things with respect to that. And I would say the best part was to lead SP access portfolio end-to-end, wherein we conceptualized, developed, launched, and deployed these products in the market. And one of them being the biggest IP MPLS network for Reliance Jio. And if I really want to sum it up, it has been a journey from 64 kbps to 1 gig on the consumer side and 64 kbps to terabits on the product side. And after almost like 18 years, then I took a plunge into the startup side. So I joined a startup in Bangalore, and this was really setting their operations here, building the team, getting things moving, and it has been a great experience understanding the world on application side away from system level engineering. I think this has been very enriching experience given the fact that world is really moving a lot more onto building applications, building software, while the networks are becoming more of your plumbing items, which are going to be always there. So it is just, on top of that, what can you really build? So it was very startling and enriching experience for me, during those 1.5 years when I was running the startup here. And then almost 1 year back, this opportunity came up in Cisco again on enterprise side. And I decided to come back and start the journey onto the enterprise networking side, while earlier I was mainly onto the service provider business side. And right now I'm leading the campus switching team in Bangalore and really, you know, happy to be part of that, because, you know, this is one area where a lot of new innovations are happening now.
Thank you, Kumaril. These are challenging times, I understand, but I'm sure challenges have been there throughout your career, because if we look at Cisco as the giant, there are multiple products, multiple releases, deploying day in, day out. So I'd like to understand the challenges that you faced and how you overcame. That would be a great lesson for us today.
Absolutely. And then this is a great question. As I was mentioning that, you know, I spent quite some time onto the service provider business side and now onto the enterprise customers. In one way, if you look at, these are very different from their needs and usage standpoint, yet there are a lot of common denominators also for both of them. And if I talk about quality and simplicity, both of them would require that, right? On the other hand, if you look at service providers, you know, they deploy networks for end users which contribute to their revenues directly. So the needs and pressure points are different. The challenges are also different from a specific angle. While enterprises, they deploy networks predominantly for their own consumption, which takes them to the ease of operation, higher productivity, you know, within their teams. So these are the kind of, you know, angles where you can look at, you know, SPs and enterprises. Now, if I really look at the challenges with respect to the service providers, one is the expanse of technology which gets deployed. It is huge. They cater to businesses, individuals, and many varied end users. And the different parts of the network have different challenges. If you talk about, say, access nodes, boot up time is very important for them. But if you go back to aggregation core side, redundancy is the key there. Whether it is at the box level, path level, these are really important for them, because at the end, they're also offering the services to their end customers, right, which cannot really have any break in between. So these are the things, you know, which become very important for whether it is SP or you talk about, you know, enterprises. Now, other part which I want to touch upon is customer issues or, you know, interactions with customers. I would say on one hand, it is a challenge. On the other side, it is big opportunity for us to learn as well. This is one challenge in my view where everyone should embrace and should go through it. I would give example of, you know, one of the service providers in India. We were deploying their mobile network and it was a big challenge, but very enriching as well. And I'll share one incident. We were deploying this network and a lot of nodes were getting deployed. I mean, these were like in almost like 50,000, 60,000 nodes were getting deployed. And for this service provider, from the deployment standpoint, they were also doing a lot of things at the same time, like laying the fiber, right? While at the same time, you're deploying the networks as well. So when we were doing that, it used to give a lot of problems for us. And we were wondering, you know, what is going on there? And after working on it, you know, with customer for almost like a month, we figured out that the fibers, what they are laying at that point of time, it had a lot of flakiness because, you know, you are changing a lot of things from the, you know, physical deployment perspective. And what we figured out is that while from the design perspective, we will consider, yes, there would be flaps. I mean, there would be fiber cut or something like that. But what was startling was that we were seeing 10,000 flaps in a day. So there were so many micro flaps which were happening and those micro flaps will cause trouble for the network, and it will conk off at one point of time, it will impact services. And this was not only the learning, I would say, but I think the great experience working with the customer and giving them the confidence that, yes, we understand where it is coming from. And this is the thing what you need to take care of from your side. And on the other hand, for the product, this was a great input because, you know, it made quality so better based on these experiences. And, I would say while one side it was a challenge, but on the other hand, it really gave us a lot of insights into what we need to do from the quality perspective on the product side. At the same time, giving confidence to the customers that, yes, you know, we are there with you and we will make sure that the network deployment and offering of the services becomes, you know, easy for you as you go forward.
Nice. Thank you so much. So you brought in this quality element, Kumaril. So, I mean, as a leader, being at helm of things, what are the differentiators that you consider both from a development, deployment, and quality deliverable standpoint?
Very, very good question, on this front. I mean, at a top level, if I look at the differentiators, you know, when you take any product into the market or you launch into the market, I think innovation to solve the use cases or the customer requirement, that is one of them. Other one, best in class quality. And the third one, I would say simplification. That is becoming, you know, very important in this, you know, evolving a new world of where it is really going. So I would say whenever we are going to be developing any new product, we have to consider the deployment scenarios throughout its life cycle. Most important of all, follow software best practices. I think it is one term which we all talk about, but when we really dig deeper into it, I think if we really embrace it and the intent is right in following these practices, I would say you are definitely going to bring out best in class quality product. Design has to be done considering not only the functional parts, but the scale as well. I think that becomes very important, you know, in this new world. And I'll talk a little bit more about that. And the other part is the testing of the product that has to consider deployment scenarios and bake in the cases to cover those. When we talk about deployment, it is about operational challenges and the changes which occur environmentally that can come into picture. As I just talked about, you know, one of the customers on the flaky fiber side. And how do you really take these learnings at that point of time, but incorporate and evangelize these going forward during your development life cycle? So I think that is where, you can really say that the quality is improving, and when you deliver it to the customers, this is really of top notch. Now, the last part, coming on to the simplification part, because, you know, that is also one of the differentiators. I have seen that in last decade, there has been a paradigm shift in the business models, how the companies are operating and how they are really taking things forward. If I look at, people used to go after getting network certifications and then manage the customer networks. And really, we needed a lot of them at that point of time. But today, if you look at from the operations standpoint, enterprises are looking to have single pane of glass where they can visualize their network, get the information regarding its usage, its utilization, quick information on failures, and take the appropriate action. Today, some of these things are getting done manually, but tomorrow, these are also moving towards automation. I would say these are the kind of steps towards, you know, self-healing networks. So that is where this part becomes most important, which differentiates your products and the solutions. Just to talk about a little bit more about it, look at the telemetry, which is becoming so important these days because it provides you insight into so many areas and gives you loads of data on what you can run your MLAI And in turn, that will help you take the appropriate and the required actions also. And this is what is going to be making the life simpler for the customers, their operations team. And this is where they can really draw the actual or the real value.
Awesome. From light combat aircraft to 1 gig speed, from building softwares to design centric solutions. You also spoke about self-healing networks. And how has the journey been? And where does all your learning come from? How do you keep yourself updated?
Yeah. So, you know, there are a couple of parts to it, Anil, if I really look at it. One, I would say that when you are interacting with the customers, talking a lot more to them, I think this is something which gives you a lot of information and insights into that what is the final way the solution is going to get deployed. And I think if this is what you can really understand, I think you can really win this battle, right? Because you are really building something which is going to be available in the market, driven by the customers, right? I mean, this is also that shift which has happened over a period of time. Earlier, I think we used to give that this is the product, take it and deploy it. Nowadays, these network elements are also becoming more of a commodity, which means we want these to be available. But on top of this, the way I'm going to be designing the network or building the applications, that is going to be, you know, my choice. So you need to really cater to those. So more you interact with the customers, I think that is what really gives you insights into that what needs to be done. And to be very frank, I think this is something which really keeps you moving also at that pace, because at the end, whatever you develop, if that gets deployed at a scale, that is the biggest satisfaction you can get.
I completely agree on that. So today, design has become the talk of the town. Softwares don't require user manuals anymore, and you don't require help and support anymore. Softwares can be learned within a fraction of a second now. So everything is simplified. Like, to put it in an easier way, we have humanized technology now. So tell me, how in your opinion is design important in this digital era?
I think you touched upon the heart of anything, you know, what we are doing as part of the development or whatever products are being, you know, delivered as well. I think this is one of the most important, you know, item, and at every stage of the life cycle of the product or whatever you're going to be deploying. I would say interpretation of design, you know, varies from maybe consumer to enterprise in one way. Say, for example, if I talk about B2C products, I mean, let us take mobile phones, right? Along with features, its aesthetics also play a big role. But if I go to B2B, like enterprise service providers, outlook would be a little bit different, while the core tenets of design wouldn't change. So design becomes important at every stage. And look at, I mean, when you are really taking the requirements, discussing about that, you know, what the product is going to be looking like. First, you need to start with the design, which is going to be catering for scale as well. I think that's the most important part. It's not only about the functionality, but about the scale also, because that is where it is going to get deployed. I'm very happy that Cisco looks at it from this angle, as we have products which do get deployed at scale. Just talking about enterprise switching, Cat9K is one of the product series which has gotten to 10 billion within 3 years of its launch. And we have multi-million switches which are deployed in the field today. Now, if I look at it from the perspective of design, the beauty of it is that we have an architecture wherein the software is leveraged across these platforms. And best part on Cat9K, along with the software, there is huge leverage from the hardware standpoint as well. So best way to design and design for scale, where you look at leveraging and keeping the architecture in a way which can be extended across the product lines. That is how this was developed, and I think results are in front of us. And if I just take it a little bit different, I would say design doesn't stop at product development alone. Design at network level has to be in a way to cater to the requirements and also to deal with any external factors or eventualities. It has to have inbuilt redundancy for service offerings. And that has to be there at network level, application level, at every part of the solution, unless until you are really designing it from the perspective where you can provide uninterrupted services to the end users. I think this is where it plays the big role.
Wonderful. Awesome. Rama?
Thank you so much, Kumaran. This was really, really great. I mean, design at scale, design at every level, I think it's exactly
what one of the best takeaways today.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for this insightful talk. I'm sure all the listeners here and in the future will enjoy this and stay tuned for more. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rama and Anil. Thank you for having me, and very happy to be part of this discussion. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kumar. Have a lovely day.
You too.
Thank you.